the previous video of the chapter 4 Poll Science Working Institution, we discussed about the Parliament. Parliament is a supreme law-making body of India. In large countries, the Parliament has two parts, the chamber or the houses. In our country, the Parliament also divided into the two houses. The lower houses means Lok Sabha and the upper houses means the Rajya Sabha. And it also consists the President office, the Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha is also known as a House of People because its members are directly elected by the peoples. And the member of the Lok Sabha also exercises real powers on the behalf of the peoples. On the other hand, the second house is the Rajya Sabha, that is also known as a Council of State because its members are indirectly elected by the state legislative assemblies and it performs the special powers. Our constitution give the Rajya Sabha some special powers over the states, but on most matter the Lok Sabha exercises supreme power. Any ordinary law needs to be passed by the both houses, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. पर अगर किसी law के लिए दोनों houses में differences create हो जाए तो final decision joint session में होता है, जहाँ पे Lok Sabha के members और Rajya Sabha के member together sit होते हैं. And because Lok Sabha has a maximum member, तो mostly decision Lok Sabha के favour में होते हैं. Lok Sabha also exercises more power in money matters. Once the Lok Sabha passes a budget of the government or any other money-related law, the Rajya Sabha cannot reject it. The Rajya Sabha can only delay it by 14 days or suggest change on it. It's wish of the Lok Sabha that they will accept the changes or the not. And the Lok Sabha also controls the Council of Ministers because the person who gets the majority from the Lok Sabha members appointed as a Prime Minister. But अगर Lok Sabha के members उनके regarding non-confidence clear कर दें तो Lok Prime Minister और उसकी Council of Ministers को quit करना पड़ता है. But Rajya Sabha has some special powers regarding the states. It look after the interest of various states, reason for the federal units. According to the Article 249, Sabha can change the state list, some subject of the state lists into the union list. And it also has a power to remove the president of the country and the Supreme Court's Chief Justice through the process of the impeachment. Now we will discuss in the detail about the composition of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The member of the parliaments are known as the MPs. Those are directly or the indirectly elected for the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The Lok Sabha has a 500 members. 530 elected from the states, 13 from the union territories, and 2 are nominated by the president, who represent the Anglo-Indian communities. And a member of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the peoples. The person who has an age of 18 or above the 18 can vote according to the universal adult franchise without any discrimination of the caste and the gender for the Lok Sabha's members. And the Lok Sabha's members are working for the 5 years. But it can earlier dissolve by the president if the Lok Sabha members get the votes against their workings. Agar opposition party parliament mein no confidence motion ke paper mein vote kar de, to prime minister aur uski council of ministers ko resign dena padta hai. And the speaker is beside the meeting of the Lok Sabha. The Rajya Sabha has 250 members, 238 elected from the states and the union territories, and 12 are nominated by the president. And they are the persons who has the highest rank from the field of the literature, art, science and the social service. And they are nominated for the 6 years because they have the provision that 1/3 member of the Rajya Sabha retires after every 2 years, and on that members new are appointed, and these members are indirectly elected from the state legislative assemblies. And now they are not totally dissolved, they are 1/3 is retired after 2 years, so that's why they are known as a permanent house. And the vice president is beside the meeting of the Rajya Sabha. Those who are execute or force the policy and the or the decision of the governments are known as the executives. In a democratic country, two categories make up the executives, that are political executive and the permanent executives. the executive, that is, elected by the people for a specific period of time, are known as the political executives. The persons who are working in the political executives are known as the political leaders, like the prime minister or the chief ministers. On the other hand, the persons who are appointed on a long-term basis to assist the governments are known as the permanent executives, and they are known as the civil services. And the person who are working for the civil service are known as the civil servants, like the IAS officer and the IPS officers. The members of the political executives have to vacate the position with a change in the government. It means when ruling party का periods over हो जाते हैं या उन्हें dissolve किया जाता है तो prime minister और उसकी council of ministers को post vacant करनी पड़ती है. But on the other hand, the member of the permanent executives are remaining in the office in the even the ruling party changes. They have to assist the ministers in carrying out the day-to-day administrations. Their civil servants are highly educated and has expert knowledge about the departments in which he works. For example, the advisor working in the finance ministry know more about economics than the finance ministers. But the ministers are more powerful than the civil servants because the minister is elected by the people and he is working on the behalf of the peoples, and he is also responsible for the answer for all the result of the decisions. That's why the minister take all the final decision. The minister decide the overall framework and objective in which decision on policy should be made. The minister is not expert in the matter of his ministry, so the minister takes the advice of the experts on all technical matters. Actually, this happens in the large organizations. The expert can tell the road, but someone with a large view decides the destination. And in a democracy, the elected minister performs this role. And in the next video, we will discuss about the head of the political executive, means the prime minister and the council of ministers. Now, topic related, these questions you have to do on your fair notebook.